And my next guest is kind of a strange one for me, as he was once my boss. Jerome Watkins.
Hey, Olivia. It's been a while.
I know you had quite a tragic start in the business.
I wouldn't call it tragic, but ironic, for sure. I spent a decade in prison for the same thing that pays my bills today. And the home stretch was right after we got legalized.
Lex retro non agit, as we lawyers say.
You were never fun at parties. Anyway, I learned a couple of things about brand management while I was on the inside. Once I got out, I wanted an honest, regular job.
And regular is quite the opposite of what you got, isn't it? After teaming up with Maddie.
Maddie was an old friend and a great guy. Surprisingly, not a great grower. But I guess his subscribers on the internet considered him a world-class expert.
Since you both started growing and selling again, I was under the impression that while he was the voice, you were the silent partner that brought a deeper knowledge of the industry. And not just tending the plants, but understanding different types of customers. Was all that useful given how things have changed?
It's a new game now. Some states have legalized recreational marijuana, but most only medical, with various qualifying conditions. There's different tax regulations, strict advertising laws. It goes on and on. And of course, the illegal market didn't just disappear. It adapted. We all had to. Which is, of course, why we originally brought you on board as our legal eagle.
With your guidance and Maddie's growing influencer clout, the business obviously got much bigger, along with the legal issues. Suddenly, you had to face the problem of interstate transport.
Another sign of idiocracy. Cannabis is still illegal federally, so any type of business related to interstate transportation falls under the federal jurisdiction.
Meaning, breaking the law. And for the record, we were never doing that during my time there.
Never. But sometimes, you're forced to do whatever is necessary to fight off the competition.
Including smart marketing. I was around when you were running your campaigns. How did it help to fend off your business adversaries?
We learned how to promote our customer-made strains where law permitted it. The trick is to find the right subject for your ads and choose a medium and language that your target audience understands. Maddie was pretty adept at making people listen to him. If he wanted to, he could even skew the reviews of a competing product.
Which is not always easy with some new competitors. Take Big Pharma, with their armies of lawyers and marketing specialists whose sole purpose is to capitalize on the cannabis gold rush.
We treat huge corporations just like ordinary competition. After all, the market validates our success. You win the customers, you win the war. I faced enemies of different backgrounds and morals. And sometimes you have to fight fire with fire and get your hands dirty.
Which wasn't easy. Not with your brand's advertisements all over town. Maddie made sure you guys weren't just providing a product, but becoming somewhat of a local cultural tour de force. But soon, he was no longer the only face of the brand.
I felt that everything we achieved gave me a voice. A voice that could be used as a catalyst for a change. Because weed is not only about business. It's a touchstone that reaches into other aspects of legislature and politics. Take the state of our healthcare system.
With the penal system, the same one that took a decade of your life.
We need deep reforms. That's why I've launched a series of public awareness campaigns. With Maddie's amazing support, with the people on my side, I could start talking to the politicians and flood them with our own ideas and proposals. I must say, I got surprisingly adept at convincing the people in charge. I guess I became an influencer myself.
So, who's Jerome Watkins today?
Maybe an elderly junior brand manager, but seriously. I want to use my experience, my story, to show how the system can't keep up with what's really going on. I guess I'm still just an ex-con. Just a chatty one.
No, Jerome. You're an example. An inspiration so people in the country and maybe even around the world take an interest in the issues surrounding marijuana and really start talking about it.